In this example, we have a table that represents our function f of x, and then we're asked to evaluate function values and also to solve for x given a function value. When working with function notation, it's important to remember that f of x is equal to y, where x would be the input for the function and y would be the output of the function. So to evaluate f of negative 3, we need to recognize that negative 3 is the x value, and this function value is going to be the corresponding y value. So we're going to go to our table, which represents our function, and look for an x value of negative 3. Notice here it is. And the corresponding y value, or function value, is the function value we're looking for. So f of negative 3 is equal to positive 7. Notice if we wanted to graph this function, f of negative 3 equals 7 represents the point with coordinates negative 3 and positive 7. To evaluate f of 1, again, we need to recognize that this means the input or the x value is positive 1. So we'll go back to our table, look for the x value of positive 1, which is here. Our function value is the corresponding y value, which in this case is negative 3. F of 1 is equal to negative 3. Our next two examples we're asked to solve. We're given that f of x equals 4, so we need to recognize that now we're given the y value, and our job is to solve for x or determine which input would have an output of positive 4. So now we'll go back to our table and look for a function value or a y value of 4, and then determine the x value. So looking at the y values or the function values, notice here's y equals 4, f of x equals 4. So when y is 4, the input or the x value is 0. So if f of x equals 4, x equals 0. And then for our last example, we have f of x equals negative 12. So this means negative 12 is the y coordinate or the function value. And our job is to find what the input would be or what x would be. So we'll go back to our table and look for a y value of negative 12, which is here. Notice when y is 12, the input would have to be positive 2, so x equals positive 2. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.